Morning, one and all, and howdy. This is ever-loving Ira Fosberg coming to you over KYOL 1000 watts of power in Benteen, entertaining all of Schuyler County. Well, it's a beautiful morning in the Big Sky Country, the first day of autumn, September 22nd. And remember, 1934 is a very good year. Slogan courtesy of the Benteen Sons of the Open Range, who'll hold their weekly meeting at the Grange Hall this Friday night.
Once I built a railroad, I made it run, made it race against time. Once I built a railroad, now it's done. Brother, can you spare a dime? Once I built a tower.
Car's coming. Major Hart lines by the looks of it.
Elroy, what can I do for you?
Nothing. Major told me to deliver this. I tried to get out of bringing it.
Take a meal with us?
No thanks, Shasta.
It's how you feel that way, Elroy. Looks like an invite. Elroy Bones is still dead against us.
Major Roland Hartline requests the pleasure of your company, dinner and dancing, Sunday evening.
You didn't mention a million there?
You know the Major's rules. No Indians, Mexicans, or college graduates allowed.
Well, I call it strange. I wonder what he wants.
Maybe he wants to make peace.
You better go and find out. You got something to wear?
You'll see.
You know what to do with these things?
I'll bet she knows.
Colonel Dahlgren, honored guests, and friends. This can be, and with God's help will be, America's century. Our country, despite a temporary spell of economic depression and an upsurge in cynicism and debunking, will weather the moral and spiritual crisis. I rise to declare my faith in the future, our future of consolidation, cooperation, and recovery, and to ask your help and sacrifice in making us strong and great once again. I offer a toast to tradition, to the heritage I serve and the values we share and that bind us together. I call upon that great spirit of adventure which carried us to victory in foreign wars and the individual enterprise which has made our great western desert bloom like the rose. For above all, America is a promise. Toast with me then, America. America, the beautiful.
Mrs. Shasta, I'm Ann Klinger, Major Hotline's guest for the weekend, and I have heard that you actually help your husband run your little ranch. I mean, you know, running the cattle and all, and grooming baby cattle.
The strongest oats must fall. The sweet things in life.
Shasta?
Major, I'm curious. Why'd you invite us here?
Enjoy your drinks. We'll talk later.
That lady wouldn't stop talking.
Pay for your dinner around here one way or the other. I was just asking the old guy why we...
Mr. Shasta, I think you're escorting the most beautiful woman at the ball. Can a beat-up old cabberman steal a dance?
Sure. Sure, I'll keep watching. In case I get the hang of it, I'll cut in.
The strongest of them must fall. How can you do?
what you've never owned. Life is just a bowl of cherries. So live and laugh at it all.
You should put on a party dress more than once a year, Mrs. Shasta. Seems a pure waste to make a cowhand out of you.
Why? It's no shame for a woman.
As the school teacher, maybe, but you deserve a lot more than living poor and making do.
You don't understand, Major. I love my husband. I enjoy my life.
Don't let the sociability fool you. I want to talk business.
Go ahead.
My people have had the oak leaf since the 70s. It's a long time. We've held out against blizzards, droughts, thieves, screwworm, cattle companies, feederlots, and bank panics. Kept our own and taken care of our own. The oak leaf stands for something.
So does the Triple S. Stands for us.
You're a fair enough cattleman, Shasta, but these days you can't make it without capital. Money. I'll give you a bonus. 5%. No, I guess I can make it 7.5% of the profits.
What profits, Midget? You're gonna have trouble selling off that scraggly herd you got.
You'll never see an offer like this again. I'm giving you a chance for once to ride with the winner.
Major, I work for myself.
You're ungrateful.
For what?
Now listen. No half-breed married to a white woman who'd have been better off married to her own kind is going to get rich off me. You'll scrounge. I'll see to it.
I've got a place in this country.
And I'll put you in it.
I hope it doesn't come to that, Major. Thanks for the invite.
Would you excuse us, please? Thank you.
Quiet.
You want to dance?
You had a fight with Hartline.
Nah, it wasn't much of a fight. He offered me a job, actually. Can you imagine me as somebody else's foreman in 20 years? He must figure I'm a pretty good old boy for a half-breed, though.
He knows how good you really are.
No, he's running his place into the dirt, and I guess he just needs somebody to bail him out. The words were choking him.
Glad you said no.
On the other hand, took his wages for years, and maybe I owe him some.
You don't owe him anything. You're making something special for us. He'd never understand.
Arm.
Second thoughts.
Wasn't so bad for a girl.
I was doing all right.
Prickly, ain't you?
It's one of Hartline's.
One Julian brought in?
Yeah.
They ought to be worth $10, $11 to us.
Well, I sure hate to disappoint you, Julian, especially after all that proud roping you did. However, I'm gonna have to take them back.
You mean I caught them for the exercise?
Those rules were made a long time ago.
We're entitled to them. Hartline's fences have been down since last winter.
Hartline's a careless man, but we're gonna abide by the rules.
You have the right of way, I believe?
They're your beef, Major. Wasted a half day bringing them to you.
I'm glad you recognize the courtesy of the range.
Could do more to deserve it.
Mind your manners. I can still help you or bury you.
No, you can't. I raise better beef. It's my whole life.
Why did you turn me down, Shasta? To be your own man? This country is littered with small men, rugged individuals, American dreamers, immigrants. You give them a lot of dangerous ideas.
Major, I ain't got my eyes set for nothing that's yours. I just want to carve out a piece for myself.
You'll learn your lesson. My roundup camp's down the road.
Collect your strays, Nate.
All right. Ken?
What you got for me?
Nothing.
Nothing? Well, now, that'd be a first in ranching neighbors, wouldn't it? Fences down all around, and none of my beef came over and got on your spread. Mind if I look over your stock?
We mind.
It's the honest way of doing business.
Major Hartline says we haven't got a one.
You're the foreman. That's the way you're gonna play it, huh, Nate?
Bad times.
Showing you up for what you are.
Yes, Brand, wouldn't you agree?
So I made a mistake. Now get out of here while I'm still holding on to my temper.
Tomorrow you go for the truck.
Okay, tomorrow you go for the truck. Whenever you're worried, you get bossy and talk tough. Well, I'm not gonna go for the truck. What do you think about that? I've been cowboying alongside you all month, every day.
Well, if times were better, we'd go get a chauffeur and he'd get the truck.
I suppose you'd like me to play auction bridge with the ladies in Ben T.
Be all right.
What are you afraid of? See, we don't have enough of a herd.
That's a fact. We don't have much of a herd.
Or is it that you don't want Heartline's men to see me working?
You ever sorry about us?
Luke Shasta. I had to run you down like that steer. The one you wouldn't let me keep.
Mark, you wanted a pass, eh?
Hey.
Cardwell.
Shasta, how are you?
Tired.
Mighty good-looking stock.
Prime.
You know, I used to be a rancher one time. I saw the business change.
All for the worse.
Big corporations are going to have it all someday. Might just as well. Can't use much of what Heartline's trying to sell.
Well, you know now, this isn't your 8-cent beef. Used to get $50, $55 a head for this kind of beef.
Yeah, only yesterday.
Could take them over to the auction at Ashland.
That's a good market.
Raisins by hand.
It'd be a shame to walk the flesh off of them. I'm offering 15 a head.
The way I figure it, I got 17 apiece, I know. That means I'll be losing $2 a head.
Lose a little on each one, make up for it in volume. That's the best I've offered all season.
I guess not.
Shasta. That's prime beef. Add 2 bits a head.
Wire my banker.
That's Hodges over in Benteen.
That's right.
You're a hard man to do business with.
Not hard enough.
How'd we do?
Best we could. Just about broke. We should have raised less cattle and a little more hell.
Sure is good beef. It's good beef, all right. It's ours.
Just pretend you're Kansas City billionaire, Moon.
Yeah, well, you want me to gather up the rest of the live bunch tomorrow?
Yeah. I think we ought to handle the brood cows, too, don't you?
Yeah, we better do that, I guess.
I wish we could afford a radio.
Yeah, well, I wish we could afford a good Indian.
Hey,
should be for it.
I love being with you. I love our place. Hey, we're getting by. And succeeding. Well, at least you're not a stuffed shirt like Hartline, pretending to be a cattle baron. Why don't you stop trying to conquer the world? Try conquering me.
You want me to drive? What's wrong with my driving?
Nothing. Looks like you're doing more thinking than driving.
Do you know anything about women?
Nope.
You ever make one happy?
They told me they were at the time. No.
What do they want?
I don't know.
Could be a bullet hole, you know. Maybe a warning. That thread's as shot as your underpants. Why are you trying to be a white man?
I ain't trying to be a white man.
What do you want, then?
Well, I guess I want the same as everybody else. Wanna love my woman? Raise some kids. Get by. Ain't afraid to work hard.
Well, don't get too happy, too prosperous.
Why do you say that?
Their God won't like it.
Their God is money, Moon. Their God is money.
Yeah, maybe so, but you better walk soft. It's another man's sky.
All the way up from Elko.
Howdy.
They're very good.
Skillful, I'll bet.
We don't see you anymore.
Got married.
I heard.
One woman man once I found a woman.
Well, one at a time. But then we get all the married guys sooner or later.
Mighty sweet temptation there, Jenny. But I don't think so.
Hey, you must be in love. We're just plain lost interest.
Got other things on my mind these days, Moon. Got business on my mind. Besides that, I don't seem to have much to work with anymore.
Yeah, but staying away from Jenny Tarver won't get you in the Chamber of Commerce.
Hadn't figured on it.
Don't get suckered in there, Mr. Businessman.
You bet.
Well, now, Major, it's not like the old days when your daddy was deciding things. Yes, sir, I know you still own stock in this bank, but since we merged... Operating expenses. Yes, I know. Well, I already spoke to Denver, and they said you were not to be given an extension without more collateral. Now, Mr. Evans made a particular point about the collateral. Major, the electric bond and share closed at 1.25 yesterday. You've got to sell cattle. Lots of cattle, Major. But I feel just as bad about this as anything, but...
It's good to see an old friend, Chester. Come on in, sit down.
Thank you. Cardwell will get in touch with you?
Yes, sir. Sale has been confirmed, all written up. And you just sign here and here to make it official. It's standard.
I understand the paperwork, thank you.
For
course, we don't have it as bad as some. Down south, the land is just blowing away. You see that in the newsreel?
No, I haven't been to a picture show in quite a while.
Things are definitely looking up. Now, your triple S is a tight operation. Now, I have it on good authority that President Roosevelt is thinking of extending the subsidy program. You're sure to qualify. Now, production control is the answer. Keep you cattlemen from cutting each other's throats.
Well, it doesn't appeal to me to have somebody pay me not to raise cattle.
Well, you made your mortgage payment this quarter. Then we have finance charges, transportation costs, underwriting, and so on, sort of carry the deal. Looks like the interest charges kind of ate you up.
This what I got for 6 months' work? Man in a vest telling me I have $244 to last over the winter with?
Well, like I said, the interest charges kind of ate you up. But once we get price supports...
Give me the money.
I'll open an account for you.
Looking out for Hartline? If I had any money, money worth buying anything with, I swear I'd bury it before I gave it to you.
Now, that's not fair. These hard times, we've all lost everything.
I never had it.
Shasta, you want to get along, go along. That's the American way.
You bet.
Chop it up three ways, ain't very much. You got suckered pretty good in there, Moon.
Well, money's like a cup of sugar anyway.
Everybody wets his finger and dips it into it.
What are you gonna do?
Get drunk. Go to Jenny Topper's.
What then?
I don't know. I'm more of the government. They gotta take care of me by treaty. Besides, cattle business is just a pastime with me anyway.
You're welcome to stay on, you know.
Hey, look, you think I'm flapjacks off? I've been to 1,000 places, left them all smiling. Hey, you worry too much. This is all just a bad dream. Besides, you can't divide 3 into 244 and come out even.
Right, you are. Drink up the difference, Moon. Have a good time with Jenny Tarvis. So long.
Here, Shasta, I'll play storekeeper for you myself, to show you there's no hard feelings.
Won't be buying much today. Thanks, Major.
I guess I can give it all a hand in advance. You need credit?
I'll pay cash.
If you want some gas, I'll unlock the pump.
No, thanks. $0.24 you overcharged me, Major.
I just put the price up.
Call that fair?
I call that power. You've got $244 to last you over the winter, less whatever you gave that Indian.
Good news travels fast. Your electric bond and share is worth $1.25. You got any buyers?
I'd better remind you who runs things.
What do you want? You want my ranch?
I'm the man you'll deal with, now or later.
Or is it something else altogether?
I want everything you've got, Shasta.
Overcharge me another 50 cents.
I just put that price up, too. Is that all you're buying?
Major, you don't own me yet. Now, I might have to skin it, or grow it, or just go hungry. But I ain't gonna shop here no more.
Got a stiff neck, Shasta. Watch where you step.
Land of the free.
Huh? And the home of the brave.
Hey, la.
Didn't expect to see you till spring.
Well, I decided to settle on a short beer. Hey, still like to drink up the difference.
You bet. Prohibition ruined the liquor trade.
Business was lousy, all right.
Well, Shasta, how's your wife take to range work?
Just fine. She likes the life.
Times I was gathering cattle, I felt I could drink the whole Green River dry.
You bet. Two Green River whiskeys, doubles, beer chasers.
I'll just bet she likes it. Living in a shack, eating them refried beans.
DJ, how long have I been drinking here?
Since the war, I guess.
First time you ever gave me anything in an Indian glass.
I suppose it is.
Didn't ask for special treatment.
It's him. I shouldn't be serving you at all, really. The boys, you know.
No, I don't know. I'm an Indian myself. Forget. Just forget it happened. I'd like to have two Green River whiskeys, doubles, beer chasers.
Isn't this place good enough for you, Shasta?
Always has been, Nate.
Well. First, you cost us money by taking away Oak Leaf cattle sales. And then you interfere with our drinking. I say you're a pain.
Anybody else want a taste? Elroy Bones.
Yeah?
Stand up. How long you known me?
15 years, off and on.
You ever known me to shirk?
You always did your share.
You ever known me to lie, cheat, welch on a bet?
Nope.
I ever double-cross you or anybody you know?
Nope.
Then why are you bull-ragging me?
The feeling around here just don't favor independence.
I was plenty good enough when I worked for Hartline. Now I bring you your strays and you don't even offer me a cup of coffee.
Different when you was one of the hands along with us before you went and quit off.
That's what you want to be all your life, Elroy. A hand?
Got a family to worry about.
You own anything?
Nope.
Neither do I.
Trouble.
We're just gonna do it their way, Moon.
Walking into Hardline, Sheriff. You need a keeper.
Just cover my flank. Sheriff.
What can I do for you boys?
Nate Rackley just jumped me over at the Oak Leaf.
Hardline's foreman?
That's right. Hardline got him to chouse me.
Well, I guess I better go talk to him.
Look, Sheriff, I just came here to tell you my side of it.
You stay here.
Home.
care. Buy yourself a Packard or a Stutz.
What's this mean? Stan?
I'd better. You're in trouble with the boss. Anyway, I like your horses. You shouldn't tell off those drugstore cowboys and the sheriff.
Well, I got a redneck moon.
Made those gringos feel inferior.
Man serves you up a bowl of dirt, you don't have to eat it.
Man has to eat a peck of it during his time in this world.
We followed the rules. Now, that was what was important.
But the game was fixed. We didn't even get our drinks.
Right you are.
Can you stay on a bronc at all?
Well, I suppose better than some. Worse than a whole lot.
I figure the rodeo soon. You might win some money.
I wouldn't bet a nickel on it.
It'll keep it triple S alive till spring. The Indian way.
For the good news?
That's it.
That's what I paid for groceries.
Wound share is in there. He's staying.
You just gotta count it.
Something happened in town.
What makes you say so?
Because you haven't had anything to drink.
Just a small beef with Nate Rackley.
Why?
They who robbed us, treated us like a couple of tramps.
You know how things work around here. Heartline School Board invented a reason to fire me when I married you.
Needs a cleaning.
Haven't used one of those things since the whip custer.
The Wild West.
Cut and shoot.
Tell you.
The man Shasta here is gonna win us a lot of money at the rodeo.
Come on, Moon, sit down.
Oh, no.
It's not gonna hurt.
Well, it sure ain't gonna help anything either.
Look, if you two are gonna rodeo, I don't want you both looking like a couple of wild Indians.
Well, it's better than Sampson and Delilah.
Don't laugh at me. I didn't ask him to look like no dude.
Still.
How's
he look?
Take a little bit more off the ears, and I'll make sure he hears a whistle.
I don't want nothing else. Oh, look, you got it all over the floor.
Still, I'll cut your ear off.
Damn, how'd I wind up with you two for partners anyhow?
We'd draw our time if there was any for us to draw.
Sampson is getting soft or something. You won't even go to Jenny Tarver's with me anymore.
Ladies and gentlemen, our 1934 Benteen Rodeo will be underway in just a moment, but first of all, may I present our official Grand Marshal, Colonel Dahlgren.
As your Grand Marshal, I am pleased to declare this 26th annual Benteen Rodeo officially open. May the best man win!
Now we're all set to move to the arena for our first rodeo action of the afternoon, and it's cap roping. Luke Shasta of Easy Valley, our first cap roper. He nods his head, calls for his cap. Now all he has to do is ride to him, rope him, dismount, throw him by any three legs with the pigging string. Down the line goes Luke Shasta. He wraps it up with the pigging string, all three legs. He throws his hands in the air, and it's mighty quick time, a 13-8 for Luke Shasta of Easy Valley. Our next cap roper will be Nate Rackley of the Oak Leaf Ranch, and you know Nate will be riding hard because he has that time of 13-8 to beat. Rides to his cap, throws his loop, he does not connect, so he will get no time in the cap roping event here today. And the cowboy coming out of chute number three is Walt Greeley, representing the Oak Leaf. They have drawn for him here today the long Sunny Jam. Walt calls for the gate out. outside, and he's fitting a good ride on his horse. There goes his hat, and right behind comes the good cowboy, Walt Greeley. You know, the old-timers have a saying, never was a horse that couldn't be rode, never a cowboy that couldn't be thrown. Well, Walt here is living proof of that today. How about a big hand for Walt Greeley of the Oak Leaf Ranch? We move now to shoot number four, and our cowboy also hails from the Oak Leaf Ranch. He is the foreman there, Nate Rackley, and he has drawn one of the tough horses here this afternoon, and we'll see if he can make the first qualified ride. Nate nods his head and calls for the gate. Here's one of the top combinations of the afternoon, the good horse PDQ and Nate Rackley. And the cowboy is in a storm. He reaches for the swells. He is kicking himself free and comes to the ground. The cowboy knows it's time to bail out. Tough luck for Nate Rackley as he fails to qualify in the Saddle Bronc riding today. Luke Shasta, our next cowboy, eases over the top of chute number three onto the storm deck of the horse, Brown Bomber. Here's a cowboy that is already placed at what he meant this afternoon. And it looks like he's marked his horse out well. He goes to the spurring motion from the shoulders back to the cattle boards. If he can get to the whistle, he will make our first qualified ride of the afternoon. He does. The judges marked their scorecards, and Luke Shasta is really showing us something here today. If he keeps this up, he'll be in contention for the all-around champion cowboy.
All right, listen. I'm sorry about what happened at the bar.
Yeah, well, you make it sound like we're just doing it for the money. Well, some of us ain't.
We move back to the chutes now for more action with one of the biggest cowboys this event, Bonnie Dellinger of Willow Canyon. He's aboard the horse they call Jughead. And let's see, marks his horse out in good fashion. The cowboy is fitting a good ride on the little sorrel horse. Wait a minute, he's hung up. He's in the stirrup. The horse is on top of him. Cowboy, see if you can help him out. They move in to take the horse away, and it looks like Monty is free from the horse. Is he all right? Well, there's the worst wreck of the afternoon. Monty Dellinger of Willow Canyon. Now the action's in the bulldogging event. And it's the Easy Valley hand, Luke Shasta. He rides out alongside his steer. The rules say he has to bring him to a stop and twist him to the ground. He rolls him over, and the flag is dropped. We check our watches, and it looks like a mighty speedy time of 15-1 for Luke Shasta. And he's always a tough bulldogger. He looks like he's going to live up to his reputation this afternoon as he twists his steer down in a hurry. That's it.
14-8.
Well, one good turn deserves another as Marty Rogers goes into the lead in this event. Ladies and gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please. In addition to the purse of $25 and the beautiful engraved trophy that will be presented to our all-around champion cowboy at the end of today by the Benteen JCs, I'm pleased to announce a matching amount has just been donated by Major Roland Hartline. This gives us a grand prize total of $50 in cash to the all-around champion cowboy.
Back behind the barrier in the dogging chute now, and he'll be coming out in a hurry because he has Marty Rogers' top time to shoot at. Rides down to his steer, reaches out, his feet behind him, and he's not able to hang on to his steer, so none of the prize money will be going to Tim this afternoon.
How's it going?
I'm sorry. What do you think of it?
Unless the judges are dead, drunk, or blind.
Speak to your gods, Moon. We sure could use that money.
Sure haven't been much of a change in hands lately, that's for sure.
Well, folks, we're just about through with our 26th annual Benteen Rodeo here this afternoon, and we've had lots of good action. A few cowboys hurt and wallered on and taking a little bit of tough luck, but we're right now ready to go with our final decision as to our all-around champion for 1934. The judges have had a tough time. They have had to retally their scores a number of times, but I understand they have reached a decision. Yes, they have.
Thank you, Ray.
It gives me a great deal of pleasure to announce the winner is none other than the Easy Valley Cowboy from the Triple S Ranch, Luke Shasta. Queen Donna Farley is presenting the all-around champion.
Oh,
champion,
oh,
champion,
oh,
champion,
oh,
champion,
oh,
champion,
oh,
champion, We thank you for being...
Ladies and gentlemen, a special announcement. To top off our day, if the winner should agree, I propose a challenge event, man to man. Alvin Fuster, representing Oakleaf, against your best, Luke Shasta.
He's done riding us yet.
Bull riding, on stock, fresh from the range. No time limit, no judges. Ride until the man is thrown, or the creature quits, or a purse of $100.
Ain't he the devil one more time?
Go for it.
I've never been on no range, Bull. All right.
What do you say, Luke Shasta?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, yes. Luke Shasta has accepted the challenge.
Need a little help back there in the shoes.
You bet. But what a great way to culminate our rodeo here this afternoon. Gentlemen, if the contestants would please come forward, our Grand Marshal will draw your stock. Keep in mind, this is a match ride to the finish on bulls right off the range that have never been ridden. And the added purse is $100, compliments of Major Roland Hartline.
What'd you say your first name was? John George Fuster, Ennis, Montana. Say, your partner's a tough rodeo hand, all right.
He'll do.
George Fuster, Ennis, Montana.
Lonnie.
It's a real pleasure, honey. You know, we was just passing through, my brother and I, Alvin, and, well, we was trying to pick up on a little winnings. You know how it is, hard times and all, but we got here too dadgum late to qualify. So the major, he's going to give us a chance to do good.
It's nice.
Now, Lonnie, I know you're not one to brag, but I figured you might want to put a little something on your man. He's part Indian.
The best part. About 50.
$50 on the purse? You got it.
One. I can say 200 more.
Well, Lon, how do I know you're good for it?
You don't. But you know who I am and where I live.
Fuster, I'd like a little of that 30.
What's your first name, Jim?
Well, we're just about ready to go with our first contestant in our match challenge ride. It's Luke Shasta getting ready in shoot number 3 on a bull they call the Red Tornado.
You get some money down?
All of it. There's some buck named Fuster or something like that.
All of it?
Yeah.
Our wintering money?
Hey, the Indian way, I trust you.
Well, I'll tell you, if I come down off of this here bull, I don't want to hear no boo-hooing out of you.
The bull, the people are expecting it. It's not polite to keep them waiting.
All right, cinch it up tight.
Our last ride is Luke Shasta. Crawls over the top of chute number 3, sticks his hand down in the handhold on his bull rope. He'll pull it up tight around the middle of the bull. Take a couple of wraps around his hand, and we will reach our moment of truth. Luke is just set to go. Nods his head, calls for the gate. And here we go. Red Tornado and Luke Shasta. 10 seconds, ladies and gentlemen, and Luke is still going strong, setting right up in the middle of Red Tornado. Can he get all the way to the finish on this bull? We will see in a moment. Luke Shasta, our cowboy from Easy Valley. He is still aboard. The cowboy clowns move in to help him out, and it looks like he is going to undo his wraps and step off. Unbelievable rodeo history made here this afternoon with a time of 29 seconds for Luke Shasta. That ride by Luke Shasta is really going to put the pressure
that
on...
That son of a buck Fuster owes me money!
Stop the car.
But those guys got our money. Whoever catches them first collects.
Yeah, I know what those Fusers are thinking. I know where they're going. Turn this car around and let's get back.
Only medicine men can read minds.
Guys could be halfway to Canada by now.
You got a better idea?
Nope.
Let's go.
Oh, this is the famous Jenny Tarver's.
Wait a minute.
Hey, I got a hand in this outfit.
You're not coming in here.
You've been coming here for years.
Jillian.
Shut your eyes, too.
Hang on to that.
It's in my boot. Mister, that's all the money we got in the world.
Get yourself a job.
You know there ain't no jobs.
There's a stake.
How'd you figure these guys gonna double back?
Moon, Jenny Tarver's is the only honest-to-God, genuine, franchise pleasure palace in 360 miles. Now, where would you go if you was a Fuster? Must think he's the only man on Earth with a full set of brains. Besides that, Heartline owns him.
Luke, are you all right?
Yeah, I am. Jenny?
I was afraid you were hurt.
Thank you. This ought to cover the damages.
Give me a couple of bucks out of my hat.
Sure.
Gotta tend to the needs of my mortal body. Janine and Renee, they came all the way from Elko.
The bull awaits.
It's okay, we'll take care of him.
Got business. Personal.
Yes, I saw.
We're gonna wait.
To all you young maidens, where you reside, beware the cowboy who swings a rawhide. He'll court you and pet you. And up the trail go in the spring on this bucking bronc. Go.
Hey, you know, you're too easy on them boys.
How you feeling?
Better than you do, boy. Better than you do.
Oh, that's no lie. Those fuses and those softies.
It's the sheriff.
All right, hang on to this.
I just made myself to home. Hope you folks don't mind. Ma'am?
My wife's well brought up, Sheriff, but I mind.
I just had my vehicle tuned. That car runs like 60.
Sheriff, what's this all about? I'm working today.
So am I. Nate Rackley just decided to press charges. Assault with intent to commit bodily harm.
That's Hartline's law.
Your boss changes his mind, and I'm arrested.
You could always post bail.
No, Sheriff, I don't think so. I don't think so. You want to cuff me?
No, not necessary.
Look, let me pay it. We'll get a lawyer.
No, I'm just going to take this real easy. I'm just going to sponge off the taxpayers for a while.
You ain't gonna like it in jail, Shasta.
You've been getting fat for years, Sheriff. I just want to see how the other half lives. Get that lawyer. Don't pay him too much. You hadn't. I sort of would rather have stayed here till those cockroaches carried me out.
You'd have gone crazy in another 5 minutes. We have a lawyer. This is Tom Sparkman.
You and I are old friends. When she called, I caught the train from Spokane. From what she tells me, there are a lot of issues involved here.
Did she tell you that we don't have much money to pay you with?
I'm used to waiting for my fees. Or eating them.
In that case, we ought to get along fine.
To tell me, Mr. Strickland, this jury still cannot reach a verdict. This is a very simple case of assault with intent to commit...
The jury. Enough to convict. Don't see it that way, Your Honor.
Mr. Strickland, defense counsel argued to move this trial to the county seat at considerable expense. I should lock you jurors in the Paradise Hotel until you agree on a verdict.
You've done that already, Judge. Won't do you any good. This jury is well and truly hung.
No doubt. Case dismissed.
Your Honor, there's a matter of my client's bail.
Remanded. Although I may order a new trial. See the clerk of court. Adjourned.
Tom.
Bryan won't have the nerve to try this one again.
Or is the Honorable Judge Lang? He's in enough hot water with the appellate division as it is.
I used to have smart friends.
Yes, who worked?
Gee,
let me get your money. Thank you.
Oh, no, you convinced me and a couple of others it was a put-up job.
It's a good friend of yours.
Thought I'd pay my respects, ma'am.
Mr. Strickland, you stood out for me and I appreciate it.
No. There's no crime to be poor, just lazy. You aren't lazy. Mrs. Shasta, you were the best teacher we ever had around here. Not any communist, like the school board said. So, see ya.
Cash isn't leaving before you leave town.
Got it.
I'll give you your money back. Hey, good luck.
Line.
We made these cattle. Raised them.
God made these cattle. Maybe it was their destiny.
What are you going to do?
Peel them and eat them. Gonna stick. We're gonna stick.
Cleared them all out.
Yep.
It's even worse than the day before.
That's what I figured.
Figured the bee had come home to his honey. You're under arrest. Again.
Where's Broomfield?
We're special deputies.
Did that give you the right to rough up my wife?
It's a sort of a posse.
What's the charge?
The usual. Cattle stealing.
You got a warrant?
Sheriff says we don't have to have one.
Sounds like I'm going to be shot trying to escape.
Tie him up.
Guns on the ground, boys.
Pick that up and get out.
Moon, you'll need another horse on the trail. You take the chestnut.
I always liked your horses.
Sorry it's not more.
We had fun. But now we've got to cast no shadows.
What will you do?
Two men riding together, sure to get caught. I'll go to my people. They'll make me hard to find. So long, Mom.
We'll see each other.
Sure. Come on.
Short goodbyes are best. You go to Strickland's. It's war now. They'll shoot me on sight. You'll be safe there. Triple S is finished.
There's got to be another way.
Jillian, I dreamed a small dream, a storekeeper's dream. It's over. I'll be back. I'll find justice on the other side of those mountains, and I'll be back. And we'll start again.
Thank you.
As I prepare you for your long journey, dear friend, I know we never had much to share except the work. Cattle trail, hungry camps, going without supper many a time. Of course, we rodeoed and got drunk and had fun till our money ran out. Loving Jill made me ambitious, Moon. I trusted Heartline's rules, but you understood. Our fight was never about money. It was about being a man. I'm sorry for what this cost you. Hear my farewell prayer, brother. I am better than my fate, for I have died with honor. Life is the dream from which death awakens me. Only the mountain endures forever.
Doesn't leave a dime's worth of sign.
You don't call this off, Major. We're about used up.
When I have him, when I have Luke Shasta.
What your people did to Mrs. Shasta and that Indian wasn't pretty. It's not gonna look good in court.
You don't know this country, Captain. My judge says he's a murderer.
It's not the Army's job, Major, to settle your personal feuds.
It's your job, like it or not. And I have Colonel Dahlgren's word on it.
What happened to my wife?
I don't know. I wasn't there. The boys, they started messing around with her. They just wanted to scare her. It got out of hand. It was Towner's idea. He started it. Why don't you just leave me here? I'll get loose by and by, but you'll be long gone. I wasn't one that done the burning. Sure, I rode along with the posse when they come to arrest you. I had to. It's hard times. I hadn't had a decent job in 18 months. I was just following orders. You'd done the same. I got a little boy and a wife in Texas. They're waiting for me to send them some money. Just to listen, don't! I didn't do it!
Work yourself loose.
Mr. Strickland, where's my wife?
I took her to the hospital after they...
Who did it?
Same men that burned you out, Heartlines. Man named Towler commenced it, I hear. Now that the word's out, they're not showing their faces. Heartlines got them working the lion camps. What are you gonna do about it? I would too.
I need a fresh mount.
The dark brown has the most bottom. Answers to the name of Ned. Hartline's offering a big reward for you.
It's not how long you live your life, Mr. Strickland. It's how. Thank you.
Teller, let a man sleep, can't you?
What man?
Miss Roosevelt's more likely to be up here than any stray cattle.
Die for $250 a month?
Uh-uh.
Where's Hartline?
He's not here. He's still out after you. I'm just looking after things.
Very careless.
Uh-huh.
Start it up. Now drive.
Shasta, I done everything you asked. We're in the middle of nowhere.
I said the boots, too.
If this is rough country, I'm liable to get crippled if I don't freeze to death.
All clear, Sheriff.
Don't turn around. Put your rifle down, put your pistol down, and then stand up.
Just a hired hand. This isn't my fight, Shasta. I swear I won't harm you or yours.
Do you know how to fly?
I'm sure about to try.
thought I'd lost you.
The only thing I ever had. Can you travel? Okay, let's go get our lives back.
Sure you want to get involved in this thing?
Let's go to work.
Okay, up and at 'em. Let's lift off this top. You get it?
Yes, sir.
This will cover it.
In your windshield? It's part of the service.
You just stay right there, keep pumping, and don't move.
What is this?
Just consider this a loan, Mr. Hodges. Yeah. This is my collateral.
Yeah, yeah.
Everything in your cash box. Open it up!
Yeah, all right. Anything you want.
Can we get out of this, Roy? I'm gonna retire. Sheriff, I believe you'll have to.
Guess you know who you're robbing.
That's right. You can tell Major Hartline this is a down payment on him.
You're gonna shoot me?
Are you kidding? We need some warm clothes and fresh horses. Can you help us out?
Certainly can. You take whatever you need. The horses are in the barn.
Okay.
Hi, honey. Just help yourself.
You bet. Line up. As for Moon.
Moon is dead.
He'll understand.
This life turns out, you know.
You start out wanting not too much. The minute you get a little bit, somebody else wants it, and they're willing to kill you for it.
You afraid?
You? Why don't you get some sleep? I'll keep watch for a while.
Come to bed with me.
I figure it'll get cold pretty soon. You can catch us. They ain't never gonna catch us.
The first time I saw you, I thought I'd never seen such a careful man. And then I heard you laugh.
Go.
Congratulations, boys!
for an hour. Nothing.
He's been hit hard.
Don't know he's dead.
I say the man's dead.
If he ain't, why get your Cadillac, Major?
Sheriff, I think you ought to go up there. See that he's taken care of.
This is your show, Major. And I ain't no hero.
You worthless. You'll be looking for a job 5 minutes after we hit town.
Elroy! Elroy!
Elroy, will you do this for me?
Major, sometimes a man has to clean out his own privy. I guess I'm quitting you.
All right, Elroy!
I'll do it.
I'll do it myself. Shasta, I have something to tell you. We can settle our score face to face. I gave you a chance to be somebody. You turned on me. A dog wouldn't do that. You fight like an Indian. You're good at killing men from behind a rock. You eat the guts out of dead animals. Well, here, let's have it out. You want it on your feet like a man, or on your belly? How do you want to be remembered?
We got no more business here. Let's go home.